Today's random object. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and click the bell so you'll be notified of upcoming videos. Young female tigers establish their first territories close to their mothers. The overlap between the female and her mother's territory reduces with time. Males, however, migrate further than their female counterparts and set out at a younger age to mark out their own area. A young male acquires territory either by seeking out an area devoid of other male tigers or by living as a transient in another male's territory until he is older and strong enough to challenge the resident male. Young males seeking to establish themselves thereby comprise the highest mortality rate, 30 to 35% per year, amongst adult tigers. To identify his territory, the male marks trees by spraying urine and anal gland secretions, as well as marking trails with scat and marking trees or the ground with their claws. Females also use these scrapes, as well as urine and scat markings. Scent markings of this type allow an individual to pick up information on another's identity, sex, and reproductive status. The females in estrus will signal their availability by scent marking more frequently and increasing their vocalizations. Although for the most part avoiding each other, tigers are not always territorial, and relationships between individuals can be complex. An adult of either sex will sometimes share its kill with others, even those who may not be related to them. George Schaller observed a male share a kill with two females and four cubs. Unlike male lions, male tigers allow females and cubs to feed on the kill before the male is finished. All involved generally seem to behave amicably, in contrast to the competitive behavior shown by a lion pride. Stephen Mills described a social feeding event in Rathmore National Park. A dominant tigress, they called Padmini, killed a 250-kilogram or 550-pound male-male guy, a very large antelope. They found her at the kill just after dawn with her three 14-month-old cubs, and they watched uninterrupted for the next 10 hours. During this period, the family was joined by two adult females and one adult male, all offspring from Padmini's previous litters, and by two unrelated tigers, one female, the other unidentified. By 3 o'clock, there were no fewer than 9 tigers around the kill. Occasionally, male tigers participate in raising cubs, usually their own, but this is extremely rare and not always well understood. In May 2015, Amur tigers were photographed by camera traps in the Sikhote Island Biosphere Reserve. The photos show a male Amur tiger pass by, followed by a female and 3 cubs, within the span of about 2 minutes. In Rathmore, male Bengal tiger raised and defended 2 orphaned female cubs after their mother had died of illness. The cubs remained under his care. He supplied them with food, protected them from his rival and sister, and apparently also trained them. Male tigers are generally more intolerant of other males within their territories than females are of other females. Territory disputes are usually solved by displays of intimidation rather than outright aggression. Several such incidents have been observed in which the subordinate tiger yielded defeat by rolling onto its back and showing its belly in a submissive posture. Once dominance has been established, the male may tolerate a subordinate within his range as long as they do not live in too close a quarters. The most aggressive disputes tend to occur between two males when a female is in estrus and sometimes resulted in the death of one of the males.